The leaders of several Lee County communities are joining forces against state water managers.
State plans to increase minimum flows from Lake Okeechobee to 400 cubic feet per second. Local mayors worry their concerns that the West Coast needs more water than that fell on deaf ears. NBC2's Jacqueline Beavis is live outside City Hall in Cape Coral, where council voted to join in legal action.
This has been a rapidly developing process throughout the day today. The Cape Coral mayor even saying during their meeting he was getting text updates from other local leaders around the county. All of this about being on board with not only a letter, but potential legal action against South Florida Water Management.
I'm not threatening, but if you want to go forward, we're prepared to go forward.
That's the message to the South Florida Water Management District from the Sanibel mayor.
It's a complicated structure, but this is a simple policy decision, and a policy decision that has no cost whatsoever.
This comes after the Water Management District increased the minimum flow by 100 cubic feet per second when West Coast mayors asked for hundreds more.
I've never seen a group go somewhere and make the type of requests or cries that fell on deaf ears as I did when I went up to the South Florida Water Management District meeting.
Before agreeing to an appeal, the Cape Council heard from voters.
Unanimous decision is a powerful decision, I think. This is 185,000 people that live in this town. They're not speaking with just their voices. They're speaking with all of our voices.
And then voted themselves to move forward alongside Sanibel.
Aye.
Aye.
Seven ayes, motion carried.
On Fort Myers Beach, council agreed to sign the letter and join in the lawsuit as well.
I'm gonna sign it right now, I'm gonna give it to you.
Accepting whatever cost may come with the legal action, knowing it's all very possible.
I'm not overly optimistic that that's gonna happen just by a little letter.
There's no reason why South Florida Water Management District can't look at this again, and we might have to force that hand is what it looks like.
I reached out to South Florida Water Management today. They told me they could not comment due to the possibility of legal action. As for other cities joining in, Fort Myers and Bonita Springs both signed the letter and said they'd consider legal action. I just got copies of that letter and the legal action that has been signed by local cities. We'll have those on the app, NBC2. Reporting live in Cape Coral, Jacqueline Beavis, NBC2.